Hey, what's up guys? How are you doing today? Welcome back to another video, and if you are new to this channel, please kindly click on the subscribe button and turn on the bell icon so anytime I upload a new video you will be notified. So here in this video I'm gonna share with you my experience, how I make money as a freelancer. So in this video, everything I'm going to show you or tell you in this video is not a scam, it's not easy, and also it's not a passive income online. But of course you are going to make a lot of money, and I'm going to share with you the real experience on how I make money as a freelancer on all of the platform I've actually used to make money online. So here, I started freelancing in the year I think that's 2017. I started freelancing, and then back then I was actually trading cryptocurrency and everything, and I noticed that I was scammed back then. So then I had to move on to freelancing, and the first service I actually offer on the I use Fiverr platform, because that was where they actually invited me to. So I used Fiverr as my site also that time. So then as time goes on, I offer Blogspot website creation like that. So that was then. So as time goes on, I proceed and I make some sales, and back then the competition is kind of like low, because if you create a gig, within 2 or 3 days you notice that your gig is on the first page on the Fiverr platform with some relevant keyword that you actually add on your gig. So then as time goes on, I keep on learning some other skills. Then I noticed that I can do some video optimization. Then I try to offer that kind of service on the Fiverr platform, and of course I trick the system. But what I actually believe in is that so far I'm not scamming anybody. Definitely I'm doing the service that any buyer actually hire me for, so I don't think that's a scam. So that back then I used to use foreigners pictures, their names and phone numbers as well, just to set up my account. And due to the fact that there are people who have actually spoiled other people's reputation, so that is the reason why I actually use foreign name, foreign picture, and then foreign profile to set up my Fiverr account back then. Then due to that, I was able to make sales, and people actually trust me on the service that I offer. So I got a lot of reviews, 5 stars, sometimes I get 4 stars, and you know, it's kind of like different buyers, so that's kind of like different perspective. So some people just like, even no matter how you try to work with them, so they are not going to satisfy. So then I noticed that the niche is kind of like getting saturated around 2018, so I decided to change my niche. So I think the people that are actually creating a lot of gigs are different kind of accounts in that niche, was like India, Pakistan and Bangladesh, like that. So I think that's just move on to another niche. So then I try like 4 or 5 niches back then. So I try WordPress website creation, I try YouTube SEO, I try Blogspot writing, post writing, then I try video creation as well. So that's around 2018 till now. So lately I noticed that I was not be able to rank my gigs around YouTube SEO, that's around 2018. So I try Blogspot, that blog post, so that was like overwhelmed, like thousands of gigs you'll be seeing there. So that was, it's not even encouraging me at all. So I just create different type of account on Fiverr platform. So I use different kind of number to verify my account, because there are websites where you can actually generate virtual numbers to use to verify your Fiverr account. So I have, back then I have like 6 Fiverr account, and if there is any issue on your Fiverr account, they will just disable your account and then you have to create another one. if they notice that you are actually running different kind of Fiverr account. So then I was so desperate, and I have to get like two different kind of system to run my different accounts. Then I get like two mobile device that time too, so I run different type of account there so that Fiverr will not notice that I'm running multiple accounts. So the niche that I actually make a lot of money out of it was YouTube SEO, because people are very, very interested in ranking their videos on YouTube. And you know, back then it's the competition is kind of like low, because you can't compare it to now where everybody like me, we are trying to make money on YouTube. So but of course my own main objective is not to make money alone. Even though I got passion for creating a video since around 2018 back then, but I don't have the courage to put my sit down in front of camera like this and be doing this kind of video. So I was like, maybe I'll try later. And if you check my videos that I started uploading, my first video, second video like that, like the first month like that. So I was doing a video whereby I was only showing my PC screen, not my face, because I was like, do people even be interested in seeing my face like this? So I was just like, but I don't think that's kind of like important, because what actually important is the information that I'm trying to pass through in the video. So I think that's the most important thing. Then I see that people are actually liking my video, and of course they are actually subscribing to my videos. So then as time goes on, I think that the YouTube SEO of the thing will definitely work for me. But lately I try some other different kind of niches, and you know, there are different niches which are actually coming up on Fiverr platform, or even every platform as well, so in which you can actually use to make more money online. Because now you see like Facebook ads, you see like copywriting, you see like branding, business name, or video ads, and all there are thousands of too much skills or category that you can actually find on the Fiverr platform which we can use to make money online. It just depends on the kind of skill you actually have. And if you don't have any skills, of course you can use or outsource the kind of job you are actually gotten on Fiverr platform to make and source the job out to people who can actually do the job for you. Then you deliver and make your money, then pay the person that actually do the job for you. But the main thing is that you just only have to have idea on how that exact thing is done, so that the buyer will definitely communicate with you, and of course you guys will understand each other and have a successful project done. Then I try some other stuff such as Instagram marketing, Instagram management, and then I was able to make some money out of it as well. Because back then there are ways in which you can actually trick Instagram as well. So I remember my friend that used to help me that time, and he's kind of like he's the best for me, because he designed this channel thumbnail, designed the banner for me, and he designed almost everything for me. And I don't think I can thank him enough, because he's so unique. I love him so much. So he was the one we tried to use Instagram bot that time. So we used to use that Instagram bot to grow Instagram accounts, Instagram followers, likes. So we create different type of accounts. Then we go to FameSwap. Yeah, I think it's FameSwap. So we go to FameSwap to sell any account that we have actually grow. I remember one account that actually grew. Like, so I am not Cristiano Ronaldo. So that was the account that I actually grew back then. So it was around 20,000 followers, and I sold it around, I think I sold it around $500 to $700 on Instagram. The person actually contacted me on Instagram that he found my ads on FameSwap. I don't know. Then he contacted me and we have a deal. Then I saw the account and some other accounts like that. I'm still growing some account, but the growth these days is kind of like different from other. That was around 2019, 2020, like that. Yeah, yeah, 2019 or 2020. So then, now the way I'm actually making my money is kind of like different this time around, because as of 2020 to this year 2021, so I try to offer different kind of different kind of skills, and of course most of them I can't actually do it myself, because I create an account on ebook writing, I create an account on branding, logo design, YouTube banner, YouTube thumbnail, I create a gig on blog post writing, I create a gig, different account, like I tweak the Fiverr system. I definitely know that I tweak the Fiverr system, but of course I'm doing all this job for people who actually hire me to for a project. So I don't think this is scam, because I offer the service they hire me for. I'm not scamming anyone, so it's not a bad idea to me. I'm not using my face. I'm using those people that are actually dead some years ago. It's easy to find online. Yeah, so I'm using those pictures to because I was like, if I use my face on different type of account, will people hire me for this job? Not that I actually believe to myself, but I was like, some people have actually spoiled their reputation. So I was just like, let me just try this way, and I think it's working for me. Then I do all my best to offer valuable content or valuable service to all those buyers, so that they'll be able to satisfy and also come back again to hire me for their project. So I don't think that's a bad idea. So then I offer different kind of service. So making money online is not easy. Making money online is not easy, and you know, this is not a passive income. There are some times like that I'll make like $500 per month, sometimes $1,000 per month, sometimes $3,000 per month. It actually depends. And some accounts I'll just make money on it, and if I think they rank the account, then I'll just sell the account, then create another account, because I can't manage multiple accounts. It will kind of be confusing. How many accounts can I even control? So I'll sell some account, then create another account. And I have some people who are actually selling an account as well, because most people are actually discouraged because Fiverr are actually disable or derank their account, in which no buyer will definitely be able to find that gig on Fiverr search. So I understand most people problems, because everyone just wants to make money, and if you are not making money, it's not actually making any sense. So some people will definitely quit and start a local service, in which a day job, in which they go there, maybe work per hour, or I don't know. So they have that kind of service. Then that was actually my stories and how I actually make money online. So my main focus now to make money online is just freelancing, and hopefully on YouTube as well. So far I'm offering a valuable content, and of course I think that people will be able to will like to watch my videos, because I'm sharing the information I'm sharing in this video, in all my videos, are unique and 100% real. So I'm not faking anything, I'm not trying to I'm not trying to trick anything or trying to gain some views or subscribers. Everything I'm sharing on my channel are actually 100% real. So thank you for watching this video. I think that's everything I have to share in this video. I just want to share my experience, because there are most of my subscribers here in this channel are most freelancers and who actually want to make more money online. So it's not a bad idea if you want to start today, or if you already started make freelancing, and of course you can make money in it, but it's not easy. Only if you are being consistent on it, and if you be consistent on it, definitely you are going to make more money on it. So thank you for watching this video, and please subscribe to this channel and click on the like button. So if you click on the like, I'll definitely know, and if you subscribe, I'll definitely know. So please subscribe to this channel, because I'll be offering more valuable videos just like this. Thank you for watching this video once again, and see you in the next video.